Hello and welcome to our Castle Illusion playthrough. Yep, in preparation for the remake of Castle Illusion, one of those prolific games on the Sega Mega Drive. we're doing a remake of the original. And the sound's coming through very quietly. Have you got your...
Monitor,
turn up the volume there.
Yeah. I am a Dark Fox, and my buddy here is...
The Last Starfighter.
And today... we're going to go and doing Mickey Mouse Castle Illusion Mega Drive version.
Yeah, now because I'm a bit of an idiot, I forgot to put in the, you know when you leave the title screen running, it tells you the story?
Yes.
So what I'll do is I'll edit that in and then start. I was in a bit of a hurry this morning and I forgot to check that I got it all.
Oh god. Now, a word about Castle Illusion. Basically, when I first played Mickey Mouse Castle of Illusion, it was on a Master System version, before I even got a chance to play it on a Mega Drive version.
And I didn't discover the Master System version until much later.
The Master System version, in my view, is a bit slightly superior, because it was more harder, it was more difficult, and it had a more sort of like clarity to it.
Yeah.
What is good about the Mega Drive version, though, is that the music is, of course, much more cooler. It's more colourful.
It definitely is cooler.
And it has a bit more life to it. So you could say it has the best of both worlds.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I've never actually played the Master System version. I'd like to at some point.
Yeah. But you've seen walkthroughs.
I've seen playthroughs on... I'm kind of biased towards the Mega Drive version, if I'm honest, because like, it's one of the first games I ever played.
Yeah.
Before I could my family could afford a video game console, I would play this around sort of like friends and cousins' houses.
Yeah.
And it was amazing. I consider this game to be kind of like a fairy tale. Not just in the story, which is very fairy tale like, but also the fact that you know they have those books from your childhood, which are quite simple, quite sort of childish in tone, but they're one of the first books you ever read or whatever. It's kind of like that for me, because it's one of the first games I ever played, so a very, very sort of sentimental attachment to this game.
Let's talk about the first world. So,
Enchanted
Forest World, I believe.
Enchanted Forest.
It's been a while. But no.
The extra life there. Make sure you hit the jump button only very slightly to get that.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to show you an exploit here. So instead of doing what you're supposed to do and rolling down the hill and ducking down there, you can actually jump over that apple.
I believe they had the apple thing in the HD version, I believe.
They did, but we're not going to talk about that just yet. We're going to do the HD version later.
I love this bit,
I love it too.
Spiders and everything. So the Master System version...
Very tranquil, this
The Master System version had something like this, with the leaves and spiders, but to a lesser degree in graphics.
You know what? If I can get hold of the Master System version, we might do a playthrough of that one too, but... no plans for doing that just yet, because I don't own it, so...
Oh, the star icon you see below you is a power icon.
Health.
That detects your health, To the bottom left hand of the screen, you have the left hand part, and it determines your health.
You'll notice in this playthrough that I actually go for points quite a lot.
Yeah.
Back when points mattered.
They
give you extra lives if you get enough points.
Yeah. I found this bit to be cool though. I wasn't really expecting that in a Mega Drive version. Playing a Master System, I wasn't expecting a forest to become dark and spooky with ghosts and shit and everything.
Wait, does it come because
didn't have the ghostly dark version?
Yeah, I've only seen like playthroughs a few times, so I don't remember it all that well.
Yeah. But yeah, the Master System version didn't have this ghostly look about it.
Yeah, I really love this part.
Yeah, I know, this part is cool. I was surprised pleasantly by playing it. But even though mushrooms are ghostly.
Yeah. Ghost mushrooms.
Ghost mushrooms.
Happens to them after they get made into Rosettas.
And we're coming up to your first boss now.
Yeah.
Cool music. Really cool music.
The Grumpy Oak, the remake calls it.
Grumpy Oak.
Now, we're almost at the end of the part here, but we'll stop the part when this boss is over and we get the...
Quickly, let me explain about the Master System bosses. They were much more harder and, you actually use real skill on them, yeah? But the thing about the Mega Drive version I love so much was, of course, the music. The music got you going.
Oh, this boss music is great.
I consider this one of the coolest boss music soundtracks in my time in the Mega Drive era. Even though the bosses here are a bit more easier than in the Master System, it's still kind of cool.
Indeed.
I wonder what happened if there was a tree like that in real life that kept on rolling over you and shit. What would
you probably
do?
Die.
Yeah, would you jump on it?
Trees are generally quite heavy. This always reminds me of the final zone in Sonic, but this game came out in 1990, and Sonic 1 was
really?
In 1991.
The final zone? Sonic 1?
Yeah, but what,
really?
The electricity, when they come down, the electric orbs that come down, they're
apples.
Reminds
me, oh, there was a Chaos Emerald, yeah, Mike. There's a Chaos Emerald. Oh,
Rainbow
Gem.
We've got to wrap it up. We wrap it up, DF, wrap it up. I love this music, by the way.
I love the music.
So, we'll see you again in Castle Illusion Part 2.
Goodbye, bitches.
I've been the Last Starfighter.
And I'm a Darkfox. I guess that's been Castle of Illusion.
See you again.
Bye.
Yeah,
it's still a Chaos Emerald in my opinion.
It's a rainbow gem.
Yeah, I know. It looks like a fucking Chaos Emerald. Yeah.